some breaking news here. Fox News alert. The president says that he is considering a pardon now for Martha Stewart and commuting the sentence of former Illinois Governor Rod Blagojevich. This is after news this morning of his pardon, full pardon, of Dinesh D'Souza, the conservative commentator. The president told reporters on board Air Force One that Blagojevich said something dumb, but that, quote, lots of politicians do, and thinks his sentence is excessive. He began a 14-year prison sentence, by the way, you'll remember, on corruption convictions back in 2012. His scheduled release date's 2024. So we'll all be paying attention to that one. Stewart, you'll remember, was convicted back in 2004 of obstructing justice and lying to the government about why she unloaded stock just before the price plummeted. The president says she, quote, used to be one of my biggest fans. Pete Hegseth is on the couch to respond to all of this.
Oh, really? Thanks for going to me. I think considering obviously can mean a lot of things. It could mean tomorrow you'll see a tweet saying it's happening, or yeah. It could mean someone put the case in front of him and he's considering it. We'll see what happens after it goes through a vetting process.
This is after this morning on Twitter he said that he planned to pardon conservative commentator Dinesh D'Souza.
That was, great.
That was not a consideration. That was
What an indication that elections have consequences. So the Obama administration literally went after this guy with the full weight of the federal government to put him in jail, and Donald Trump says, "You're pardoned." And he has the prerogative to do so. It's one of the very few, you know, almost unlimited presidential powers.
Which is why he loves it.
I would love it.
But I think, so there's another case. There's a case of a man named Matthew Charles, who Dana Perino did it on her show 2 days ago, and The Five did it last night. He was in jail for 21 years of a 35-year drug dealing sentence. He got released. Turned out there was the government had made a mistake. They're trying to put him back in jail for 10 years. This is one of the cases Kim Kardashian has actually tweeted about. There are good candidates for pardons. I also love Martha Stewart.
Are you suggesting
personally that
Martha Stewart and Rod Blagojevich are not?
You know, I don't think Dinesh D'Souza was necessarily, but Pete is right. It is a very unlimited executive power.
Do you think that politically, or?
Well, I think that if Obama had pardoned someone on the left, there would be a lot of outrage. But people like Matthew Charles, who there was a real unjust situation here.
But let's talk Rod Blagojevich, because let me take you all back to the days of Rod Blagojevich. Yeah. Remember, he was leaving for his runs, and I mean, do you remember the constant
Blago world? Are you kidding? How can we forget that?
All right, so here's what the president told reporters. Getting more specific here, Blagojevich had said something stupid, but that it was similar to what other politicians have said. He called the 18-year sentence really unfair. He said plenty of other politicians could have said a lot worse, and he suggested he was more interested in curtailing his sentence than a full pardon. Important to get that in there.
Interesting.
Yeah, so short of 2024, obviously.
You know, I don't know. That it was pretty blatant when you listen to those phone calls of what Blagojevich, you know, did originally. That's the only time I'm going to try and say his name. I'm not going to do it again because it's too hard.
Just call him Blago.
Yeah. I think I actually think the Martha Stewart one is more fascinating because that's the one that is completely, you know, contemporary to what we're talking about today, where, you know, it was they felt like she did something, they chased her down, and in the end they got her for lying. And I think that they may be making a little point with that one.
Oh, remember.